So when things get really rough like that, and maybe how I felt, and maybe how you feel during it, sometimes we just want to, it's our buddy. He come to live with us at home, and he helps all of us have a better time because he takes it all on himself. I mean, come on, you know, pink, naked chicken that looks very distressed. He just takes it on himself all the time. I never see him in a peaceful situation. Right. So let me catch up. We're going to go from the start. Terrorist infiltrators. Now, this is about Facebook, because there's a lot of things I like to do, because this started with updates. So I'm going to give you a little update. And I'm not going to give you the details, because I'm going to point to where you can get them. That doesn't take up the time. So this is on Facebook. It's a video. Now, this is a young lady that is brave in telling the facts. She's a researcher, and she's received a number of death threats. Why? Because she tells the truth. I will say that she gets a little excited towards the end, and she vents. Both the videos I'm about to tell you are about 15 minutes long. So a couple of the words that she uses later on when she starts venting are not what you call G-rated. And the next one I'm going to tell you about, they're not exactly called G-rated either. And when I tell you who it is, you'll know why. But that they're going to give you the facts and the data and everything that you can easily check and back up. It will be shocking because you're not getting it in the news. Okay, another one that was on Facebook, but you can find this online. It's been taken off several times, and it keeps being reloaded because, you know, we do have freedom in this country, right? As long as somebody's not trying to steal it 24/7. So this guy's name is Chaziel Sons. Chaziel Sons speaks out. Who is he? He's a former Black Lives Matter member. This is a serious, dedicated, sold out to the deal until he found out what's been happening. This goes back to terrorist infiltrators. So check that out. Infiltrators from and into Antifa. I could go off on that, but there's another thing to find out about that. The rhetoric is just, you've got to have critical thinking. I'm going to talk about that more. But what are these Antifa? So that's anti-fascist. They are not only fascists, they are the most critical, radical fascists that they are, and they come right out of the roots, historically, factually, from the Hitler Youth, okay? Plus, in BLM organizations, LGBT, and many other groups that people, that the people or their causes do not matter whatsoever. They are simply there to use them for their own agenda. Some have said that they are loosely organized groups. I've heard some of the leaders, senators, and governors saying that. Not true. But the infiltrators and the highly organized are overly funded. They are not just working through all groups possible in this country, but others as well. Don't forget, this pandemic and shutdown was throughout most of the world, not just the U.S. Now, the disguised destruction violent riots called protest are unfounded when investigating the facts with critical thinking. But it doesn't matter, because the whole goal is to provoke, destroy, damage, and murder, all for the purpose of tearing into the core of this country to overthrow it through anarchy. Those who are innocently duped into participating are being used for a totally separate agenda that is not to fix, to change, to get recognition for anything concerning the rhetoric. Common to find the most radical communists and others bent on destruction and eradication of our Constitution in these groups. They're bent on destroying our independence and any resemblance of the greatest country in the world, plus any other country that has any resemblance of law and order. These news sources are too biased to tell the truth. When they do, it is spun in such a way to assist the damage and rhetoric. We can pray for unity and for all evil to be exposed in the light for all to see. Now, you've heard me say about the prayer, Unite 714. And that's still going on around the world. So I'm mentioning that again. What we do is we're praying that every day. And what I do at the end of that prayer is I add the other things that we need to add. And I'm going to, hopefully you'll see what we're going to, if you're doing critical thinking while you're watching this, you'll get it. So these truly evil forces behind the radicals and those who plan for them and financially support these domestic terrorists here and in other countries to be cut off, confused, revealed to all. And as God has done before, to turn them against each other and no one else is harmed. But if they truly repent and change to help reveal and stop these demonic, senseless attacks on innocent people and against our law and order, great. You know, when I see this stuff, I well up. I well up as a Christian seeing the evil. I well up as a patriot, American patriot, of people trying to tear down our nation and seeing through the lies and the rhetoric and the Pied Piper that's leading them. But that's exactly what they want. Don't get all revved up. See it with critical thinking, pause, take deep breaths, and take appropriate action. Otherwise, I want them to be dealt with so to be an example for no one else to ever follow in their tracks. As we're winding that. Now, for legitimate protests, for legitimate reasons, there is no more free country than the United States to conduct them and be received. Nothing is perfect where humans are involved, and never will be. But Dr. Martin Luther King, now we're talking about my time, not a history book, brought about more good change than all the others from that time until now. And he did it with prayer and peaceful protest, despite the true mistreatment and abuse at the time. But whether underground infiltrated groups and protesters back then as well, because that was the serious radicals that were going on, and the communists were involved with there, and I'm not talking about regular communists like Russia, I'm talking about serious crazy radicals. They only want anarchy. They don't want some kind of communist government. They don't want a socialist government. It's anarchy. Some of their members are leaders in Antifa now. If we can see through to the truth of what is happening in those so-called pandemic and protest and the things planned to come over the next few months, and don't just trust what you hear, but investigate with critical thinking and take all of it to God in prayer, in faith, not fear. He will show you His steadfastness, faithfulness, and that no matter what happens or is threatened to happen, God has the last say. Period. Fear not, seeking Him and trusting Him. For He is the answer. He is peace. He is love. Pray for all to turn to Him and seek the truth, which is found only in Him because He is truth. I have about 6 more hours to summarize, but this is a good place to say period. All right? So I want to give you another little tip here. There is a news source. I don't like to watch news. I don't like what it's about. A long time ago, there used to be a thing called news, and even though it had a level of spin, it was still news. Now it's very hard to find. So there is a news source that actually presents the news, comparatively the best you can get, national and international, called One America News, OAN, One America News. It is a cable news station. You thought I was going to say Fox, right? So again, with critical thinking, it's easy to see the spin on the facts, whoever presents them. Don't watch news often. I don't watch it often. I don't suggest you do. But when I feel there's a need to be updated, I limit my time to that exposure. Occasionally, there is a special run on OAN, One American News. Recently, there was one titled Antifa-America Under Siege. That was in the past week or so, within the past week. It was very good, laying out the history, the facts. It's not a commentary. It's laying out the history and the facts with people to verify that. And there are things that are easy to check. And I always advise you, whatever information you get, check it. Don't check it with somebody else's opinion. Check it with historical facts. They did a historical investigation look at our current situation and presented the facts and history with interviews. I guess I should have read that, right? From key people. If you can find it, it's worth watching. Get the facts. A lot of times after OAN runs a special, because they do that when there's things that change. Other sources put it out, other news and social media and things, but they put their spin on it. Where do I stand? Because everybody's talking about, where do you stand? Do you stand on this side, on that side, on the other side? So I'll tell you, as a patriot, where I stand. You know I never talk about parties, but I will say where I stand, and I'm a patriot for. I'm for the United States of America and why it was established, built, and what it stands for, our Constitution, our Bill of Rights, our Declaration of Independence. Just know that our Constitution, I know you probably know this, but keep remembering, it is the world's longest surviving written charter of government in the history of the world. Quote, it's worth another one. The world's longest surviving written charter of government in the history of the world. We are the greatest country based on following it, not destroying it. Above all, what has made this country so great and remains the best option? Most of all, honoring God. It's the foundation and the freedom to worship Him. But sources are strategically working hard and fast to strip it all away and turn us into what many other countries have tried and failed. We already have what works. We just need to keep and protect it all the way. So guess what? I noticed what was shocking, especially in Texas, and I mentioned this before, but it's still shocking. This must be the least amount of mosquitoes I have ever seen in my entire life. I was raised in Texas. And, you know, typically about this time of year, when we open our front door, we kind of do it like this. Because even though we put, you know, essential oils and everything else, because we don't want to use chemicals, and put it all out there, open that door and you can see the mosquitoes all over the door, ready to attack. You can open that door now and where's the mosquitoes? Where's the mosquitoes? That's awesome. I don't like them. They don't bother me that much, but the rest of my family, they just like a lot of people. They swell up and whelps and everything else and react. Now I have some testimonies and some other interesting bits of information to share. I've got some different things going on here. So let me do this one. This is from Catherine. She's an RN who took my class in Muskogee, Michigan. So anybody from Muskogee or Michigan, hello to you. Then she writes a lot about this technology to make her point. So I'm gonna get to the point. The point is, after she explains all that, that Kathy, the one that's working and testing her, told me that the physicians using dietary interventions who are using this system that they're testing her with feel that a 0.3% increase in phase angle over 6 months is a significant improvement. My word, she says. My hand is over my mouth in shock. I had a 0.5 increase in just overnight. From what? From the median sequence and paying special attention to the coccyx, the tip of the coccyx, to get it in really, really good. We use the word to ground it. You know that's a bridge, those that know TKM. So to really ground that in, to get that established. There's something else. I shared a book with you before, right? So that was Electromagnetic Man, some really great scientific physics dry reading. I want to share another one. This is important. A more excellent way. What is it? It is teaching on the spiritual roots of disease. I talk all the time about the roots of disease. And I'm talking about emotional. And then after I explain all that and make the connections, what do I say trumps all of that? Spiritual. Spiritual is the top. So this is really good. I think all the books are great, and he gives insight into some areas that I've not seen anybody else provide insight into. So I would recommend that for good reading. So we talked about critical thinking. You've heard me mention that, right? So some people know what I'm talking about, and maybe we need more clarification. Can I cover that for a moment? So if you're desiring a better understanding of that, let's look at it for a moment. Critical thinking definition, the objective analysis and evaluation of an issue in order to form a judgment. So in other words, you're not going in with preconceived ideas. You're open in your thinking, but with discernment. So example, here's an example of critical thinking. Professors often find it difficult to encourage critical thinking amongst their students. Amen. I don't know what else to say to that. So what exactly is critical thinking? Critical thinking is the intellectually disciplined process of actively and skillfully conceptualizing, applying, analyzing, and/or evaluating information gathered from or generated by observation, experience, reflection, reasoning, or communication. For what? As a guide to belief and action. The skills that we need in order to be able to think critically are varied and include observation, analysis, interpretation, reflection, evaluation, inference, explanation, problem solving, and decision making. So to simplify it, what is critical thinking in very simple words? Critical thinking means making reasoned judgments that are logical and well thought out. It is a way of thinking in which you don't simply accept all arguments and conclusions you're exposed to, but rather have an attitude involving questioning such arguments and conclusions. Questioning. We need to exercise critical thinking as American citizens, patriots, and especially in our faith. As a Christian, it is vital everywhere in our life. There is nothing that is not being challenged today. I hope that was helpful, because I am going to continue to think about critical thinking. So I talked earlier about prayer and about unity, right? So do you want to know what happens? So let me ask you this. Maybe I shouldn't give a hint. What is the root core of what's against unity? Satan. Now, some people will say, well, I don't believe in Satan. Well, then how do you believe in God if you don't believe in Satan? Because in natural law and everything in God's creation, there's always an opposite. There's an opposition. So I want to give you something here. So this is what happens pertaining to our country when there is division. And the prince of division is the enemy. So we have lots of wars. But you see the top one, the Civil War, where we turn against ourselves. More than 620,000 killed when we turn on ourselves. Some have estimated it's as high as 850,000. Compared to what? World War II, the Vietnam War. How about all of the others put together? We need unity. Unity. That's why these anarchists want division, because nothing can stand when there's division. It's not about one party and another party, or one color and another color, or flavor, or however you want to call it. We are all God's children. It doesn't matter what language you speak, what your education is, whether you live north, south, other side of the tracks, whatever it is, we are children of God. Whether you accept Him or not, we are all brothers and sisters. And if we don't stand together, the evil ones, the ones who are the humans that are God's children, that are letting evil prevail in their life and their stinking thinking, are going to split everybody, just like you see everywhere. The root of it is division. You have to come together. You have to come together. Do it with what? How do you come together easily? Critical thinking. Love and critical thinking. I know there's something else you want, right? Let me give you a word today. How's this? Zechariah 4:6. Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit. So that's who we put first in everything, says the Lord. So what do? We pray and be good stewards and witnesses of the truth. So this is an older one that I have mentioned in a class recently, But it says, I'm not familiar with the seizure recipe. And I forgot this. When I was teaching a class one time, I put some correlations up on the chart and I just called it a seizure recipe. Just coined a phrase. Well, it stuck. I forgot it and other people remembered and spread it all over the place. So it says, I need this for my little girl with 100+ myoclonic seizures a day. Well, so this is from Danae. It says, last summer and fall, we were really struggling in getting Jacob's seizures under control. Well, now it's been 5 months since he's had his last seizure. This is so amazing. He was having 30 to 45 minute seizures during which he would stop breathing. This was happening about every 3 weeks. The difference came after Linda, thank you, Linda, gave us what Dr. King calls the seizure recipe that I forgot. So a week later, so they started doing the sequences on September 19th, and a week later, he had a brief one and none since. Did you get that? They start applying it. Applying what? In green, gallbladder sequence, liver sequence, number 4 sequence, number 5, 6, 7, 8 combination sequence, number 9 sequence, and number 14 sequence. So he's been healthy too. Such improvements in our stress level in our entire house. Because if you've got someone in a house that has seizures, you can understand what they mean. He's made such progress in the last few months because he's been much more stable health-wise as well. So not just stopping seizures. So the root for most of them, so in my history, the root was here because it was traced to scar tissue between L4 and L5. But there's more of the pathway of gallbladder in the head than any other pathway. So whether it is like a root cause like mine was, this is something that's still going to be critical for brain function. If you'll notice, remember, gallbladder is also a waist level project. So it's working waist level and it's working the head and the brain. Liver is also waist level, and that also goes through the cerebrum. Now you have pathways of gallbladder and head. This goes right through the cerebrum. It's the only one in the chapter of organ energy that has an illustration of the brain in the figure. And then there's the 4. Need I say more? Study it. Inward destructive behavior. There's nothing more destructive than a seizure for self. 5, 6, 7, 8, because it works waist level and the head and the opposite end of the body, the big toe, which goes to the center of the brain. So much there. 9, to let go, works with waist level, the mind. Waist level, the mind. So basically these are supportive. This is in the order of priority. No matter what the cause of a seizure is. So this would be good to use for anybody, any type of seizure, under any circumstances. And then if you know pulses and do some body checking, history checking, pulse checking to discern exactly what the true root cause is, then you include that and focus on that as a priority, and you can still use all of this for support. Got it? Oh, you want more? Well, first let's read this one other thing. It is time, because I've heard from some people back in the beginning, back when we didn't fully understand what was going on in the pandemic, is that I said you might want to back off of doing flushes and cleanses and things like that to keep your immune system up. Okay, we're done with that. The middle of April was the peak of this so-called coronavirus, which coronaviruses have always been around. And I don't want to take time to talk about the numbers and the lies that are spread over everywhere. I don't know of a single source, and I talked to a number of doctors that are just fed up. They can't trust the NIH, they can't trust the CDC, they can't trust their state boards, they can't trust any of the information that's going down based on all the training and education that they've had, all the scientific facts that are due to medical research that we've always used and followed, because they're flip-flopping all over the place and it's contradicting common sense in medical science. So, you can restart your flushes and your cleanses and your full health programs. I would go right back to that. And let me also say, there was a comment that I heard yesterday, in fact, that when I say, I would like your opinion, what do you not want to hear anymore? What do you want to hear more of? What are your suggestions? What's your feedback and your questions to contact us? And they said, well, we would, but we don't know where. Well, now you do. It's our main email address. You can find it on our website. I'd love to hear from you, okay? So we've got that, and we got so much more good stuff. Where do we go? I wanted to give you this because it's written in black. I suppose you've already written that down. To increase your heart rate when it has been decreased. There it is. And it's written on the board. I'll show it to you in a minute. And it is very unusual. Is it not very unusual? I mean, your right goes between T8 and T9, so that's the disc area between the spinous process, and your left thumb goes to the right 7, which is the pad of the big toe. So it doesn't increase your heart rate if it's normal. That's when it's too slow, it will increase it. And we do run across those projects. So what if it's increased and you need to decrease it? You do something similar, but very different. So for this one, the left hand, and it is important which hand is used, okay? So left hand to thoracic 2, and the right thumb to left number 7. And again, that 7 is the pad of the big toe. Those are also going to be coming out in the app, the new app, the one we've been talking about for how many decades? Yeah, so when it comes out, the reason is we got to get it right. That's what we got to get. So I covered that. Did you know? A tip, you want a tip? Lung energy regulates energy for the entire body. And what we're having across the nation and the world right now is people that are having major complications because of problems with lung energy. So it helps all of the body. You want to take care of that very good. I was going to give you a couple of others. So let's stick it related to that lung energy. Obviously, it helps breathing. It helps people dealing with rejection. It also helps incoherent speech. It helps people that are grasping, gripping, or holding on to material things, which can, how would you say, constipate you. So it also helps constipation. If you notice in the Mimi syndrome and the holding on to things and the materialistic things of the world, we have a serious pandemic of constipation. And most people don't think so because they have bowel movements like everybody else, but they don't understand that everybody's constipated. Yes, therefore, yes, okay, got it? So, critical ages for lung are 11 through 13. That's why you want to keep these youngins in really good health and condition. So I think we can wrap that. That was the essential. I've got tons more to say, but we've got another one coming up next Friday. And yes, I do want to hear from you in between. Don't get caught up in the waves and the torment of things going on. There has been prophecy, and prophecy is fulfilling. It started fulfilling right after it was done. I don't have time for that, but the point is, God's in control. Our job is to pray, to be at peace, to be a witness, to use critical thinking and everything in our life so we don't get fooled into traps, that we don't walk into blindness. As God says in His Word, you know what serpents are. So we are to be as wise as serpents. We're not to be serpents, but we got to understand the enemy. We got to understand to recognize when it's the enemy, that we do the right things. So peace and stay in love in your thoughts and in your heart. Everything's going to be okay if we keep the relationship, not the religion. Keep the relationship. So God bless you, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.